Hi, welcome to automationtesting.in. In this video, we are going to see XPath in Selenium part 2. In the previous video, we have discussed some of the XPath scenarios. Here, we will see the remaining things in part 2. In the previous one, we have seen like what is XPath, you know, how it looks like, what are the types of XPath, absolute and relative. We discussed about absolute XPath, what is that, and relative XPath, differences between these two, which is better one. And we have seen like in the relative XPath, we have so many methods till here, what do you say, like text means till here we have seen this. And in this video, we are see from ancestor and preceding node, descendant, following node, these kind of things, methods will be discussed in this video. And now coming to we have seen this one in the previous video. Now we'll come to ancestor. What is ancestor? Selects all ancestors. You took one particular element, it will definitely have some ancestors, means parents and parent node, grandparent nodes, etc. will be there. Then if you want to select all those things, and one thing is that this ancestor, preceding, following, these kind of methods will not useful much when you write XPath. But there is a scenario, in some worst scenarios you have to use this one also. So better to have a knowledge on these things also, then you will not lag anywhere in the while writing the XPath. So select all ancestors of a particular element. Like we'll take one example. This is one example. Like I'll go to this one, go to the register page. When you come to here, that if you take your XPath and copy paste here, see here this element means text equal to full name. This is the element we are first targeting. This is the element. Okay, this element label text equal to full name, and this element ancestors we are finding. Okay, the full name ancestors. Then if you come to here, like the syntax is then double slash ancestor div. Like if you put double slash or single slash, whatever it may be, then it will selects all the ancestors of this element. You see four matching nodes here, four matching nodes. Then if you observe the HTML, like this is what where the full name is, this div. See, if you expand this div, you can see this label. Means it is not selecting this label, but its parents and grandparents it is selecting. Means this label parent is this div, this label this div parent is this div. Means obviously this div is this div is parent div, this is parent div of this label. But coming to here, this is grandparent. Okay, this is grandparent of this. If you go this one also, it is also grandparent of this one. Okay, this way it will select in particular section the parents and grandparents. Okay, when you use ancestors, it will select parent nodes and grandparent nodes. Means it is not touching the things which are there in the automation demo side, in this logo and this menu, it is not selecting. Why? Because it selects only its ancestors, means parent and grandparents. Okay, this is its sibling section, and headers are siblings. Means this is separate node and this is separate node. So it will select only till this this one, this div. Okay, this way you can find the ancestor elements of a particular element. Now we will see preceding. Preceding means select all nodes that appear before the current node in the document, except ancestors, attribute nodes and namespace. Means you can say in preceding it ignores ancestors, then it will select all the elements which are appear before this current node. If you copy paste this one, I'm taking the same full name, and I'm taking the, instead of ancestor, preceding, divs. In the preceding, I'm targeting only divs. If you want some other tags, you can say. If you say some, you have anything spans? See, you have spans also. But here we took as example as divs. Then you'll come to know exactly. See, in the previous, it selected only this area. It means it selected related to this area. It ignored all this area, this area, this area. It did not highlight it. But in this, if you come to the preceding, it not highlighting these elements, but these elements it is highlighting apart from this. So this way, preceding will find the elements which are before this current node, and it will ignore its ancestors. This way, if you want, means you took base as this one. Your base is this one. By taking this one, you are selecting these elements. Okay, this way you can use preceding. These methods will not always useful, but sometimes we will not come to know that when it will useful. But you should have a knowledge on that, what is preceding and what is following, what is like ancestor, something like that. If you come to the descendant selects all children and grandchildren. It is opposite of ancestor. Okay, it is opposite of ancestor. Ancestor will select the elements of parents and grandparents. Here, children and grandchildren. If you come here and what say, if you paste here, our source is same thing, full name. So if you come here, see, it is highlighting all the child. Means here our target node is ID equal to bootstrap form. It is a form. Actually, it is a form. What? This form. Okay? Means this form. This form had some children. This div is children and this div is children. But these are grandchildrens. Okay? What do you say? One sec. I'll take it a bit up. Then you can identify that. You see, this is child, this is child, this is child, this is child. But child has some childs. These are grandchild. This is child and this is grandchild. Okay? This way, if you use descendant, then it will highlight the childs and grandchilds. Okay? Now we will see one more method. Once you come here, then you can say like which one you want. Div 1, okay? Only this, it will take div 1. In the div 1, you have some divs. Then you can say like div, okay? You have these divs. And then if you have something div of 1, and div of 1, see, it highlights like this. If you don't have something to highlight this cricket, this checkbox, then you can follow this kind of pattern. Okay? Now if you go to next one, it's the following. Selects everything in the document after the closing tag of the current node. Means, if you say this one, it will also select all the elements of this current node. Means like, if you say here, you see, it is taking all the elements under this node. Okay, if it is form tag, is form tag, which we know. See, this is the one. See, this is the one. And it highlighted all the nodes of, see, this one, this nodes. After closing this one, you have some other nodes, this div and this div footer. If you come here, till now we did not took footer. See, in the footer also it is highlighting the elements. Means this following will take all the the current node which is having the section, apart from that its siblings. See, section is here. In this you have something, it highlighted this information, along that it highlighted footer information also. This way you can identify, depending upon the scenario where you want to write this kind of, normally it will not much useful, but if you know XPath means you should know this information also. Otherwise, like Some scenarios will come, then you will find difficulty that how to identify this element. Okay, these are the remaining methods which we left here, like ancestor, preceding, descendant, following in the previous video. And now a few more points we need to discuss, like what is direct child, what is sub child. Okay, I'll take this example, and now we'll understand that what is direct child, indirect child kind of. I'll go to this section web table. Okay, here you can find web table. You can practice here, like how to click on this edit, how to click on this delete kind of things. And if you paste here, you see that I'm using the contains method here. Why? Because I want to highlight this one. See, div id equal, there are some random number and then grid container. See, if I take this one entire id, if it is changing frequently, means this number changing frequently, then it will fail to identify. So what I took contains, this is a div tag, it contains id containing this one. This is static, grid container is static. So which id is containing this one, you highlight that one. See, then it identified that element. It identified this web table. Now I want to see direct childs of this div, then you have to use single slash. If you use single slash, it will highlight the direct child. This is parent node. It have two childs. See, here you can see two matching nodes. It had two childs, means direct child. These are direct childs. Okay, in this you have some other divs. See, here one more div. If you go here, you have one more div. If you go here, one more div, another divs. But it is not highlighting those things. Why? Because these are all not direct childs to this div. So if you use single slash, and div, it highlights the direct childs. If you say something like, if you have anything specific that everything is a div, right? Any other tags, span, you have span. If you say span, see, it is not showing anything, that it doesn't have any span direct childs. It doesn't have any span direct childs. So it will only highlight the immediate childs. Okay, this is direct child. What is subchild? Subchild means the same thing. Instead of writing a single slash, if you use double slash, it will highlight all the childs and subchilds. You see that actually this is a direct child. In that you have another child, another div as a child, means all the grandchildren also, means grandchilds also it will highlight if you use div, means double slash. Direct child and indirect childs it will highlight, okay, if you use double slash. Now, as we discussed in the previous, if you use single slash, it didn't show anything. But if you want to see spans also, if you just use double slash, see, it is highlighting spans also. The reason is, it is subchild of this one. If you want to highlight or recognize subchilds of particular node, then you can use double slash. Use double slash, then it will highlight the subchilds which are there in the now if you want the okay, we'll see, like parent element. Okay, now I want only this span, first span. How you will take this first span? So you have to take index in XPath. This way you can say this is index. If you say highlight, this identifies only this span. It is ignoring this span, because index, you have two spans, in that this is first span. If you say second index, it will highlight second one. This way you can say particular element also. Now parent element, by using child you want to highlight. Till now we have seen that parent element, child, subchild. Now I want to go backward, like I know the child one, I want to highlight the identify the parent one. See, till here it identifies this table. Its parent, what is its parent? If you take this one, its parent is this div. this div doesn't have anything specific. It is a class. If you use that class, so many elements may highlight. But I have something to uniquely identify this one. So if you want to identify this element uniquely, the base is this one. Why? Because this is easily identified. So I'll take this one. Based on this, I'll identify the parent element. How I'll do that one? This is immediate parent, right? So I'll take one single slash. Then you use two dots. If you use two dots and hit enter, see, it highlighted this element. Where it is grid container? It is in this one. You see, this is the one, right? Base one. We took this as a base here. And to identify that element, I took one single slash and two dots. Then it will highlight the parent. If you want to highlight this parent, where is this parent? This is its parent. Put one more slash and two double dots. You see, it highlighted this one. If you go here, you have this one. If you go here, this have this div. Means this is the base actually. By taking this, we are constructing it its parent XPath. This way you can find the parent XPath of a particular node. Okay. Now, next sibling. Okay, next sibling. I'll say like, if I come here, I'll paste it here. If you come here, you see it is highlighting this one, this area, some area. How it is highlighting? The same way we took grid container, it's web table. After web table, it is going towards, means till here, its parent. Till its parent. From that parent, you are coming back. Means if I say div, it is having three matching nodes. Okay, if you come here, like, see, this is parent, right? The base is this one. We are taking this div ID as base, and we are taking its parent node till here. Means we are going till here. Then it is having three divs. 1, 2, 3. See, it is highlighting three nodes. Means, what do you say? You can next sibling. By taking this one, I'm identifying. See, these three are siblings, right? They're in same range. Its parent is same. So these three are siblings. By taking this one, I want to highlight its sibling. How you'll highlight its sibling based on this node? So I'll moving backward one step to the parent, and from there I'm coming back to the sibling. This way you can handle one node's sibling using this pattern. Using this pattern. Okay, and one more thing, finding more than one element. Okay, till now we are identifying unique elements, right? Now I want to highlight more than one elements which is having the same XPath. If I say like this, see, it is identifying two divs. Means in this grid container we have two divs. If you say this one, simple div, it highlights more than one element. See, two matching elements. Means when you want to find how many tails are there in web table, okay, then you have to find the count of how many tails are there. When you will use driver dot find elements by dot XPath, then you can take the size in Java. Otherwise you can take the count in C#. That way you can find how many elements are there in the particular node. Okay, this way you can find more than one element. Now we'll see the conclusion, what it is. Here the conclusion is, need to identify the element uniquely on the web page to interact with exactly. You have a web page, you want to automate that, and you have so many web elements. If you want to interact with a single element, you have to identify that element uniquely. For that, you have to use XPath in such a way that we don't know like which type of method will suffice that requirement. Then you will use any one of these methods and you will find the element uniquely. The above are the only examples to demonstrate. Those XPaths will vary depending on the application and how the XML is written. Means till now what we saw is dependent on this application, which we are seeing demo.automation.testing.in. But if comes to your real-time application, it might be different. Means methods will be same, but the divs and spans will be different. So you have to go through your HTML or XML, then you have to write your own XPaths to identify the element. Okay, that's all in this video. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to Automation Testing Channel and please like us at our Facebook page.